listen here. The range of the relation R equal to x comma x squared such that x is a prime number less than 13 is. They have given four options. Actually, what are they asking? The range of the function is dash. The range of the function. The range of the relation is dash. So actually, relation is what? X or y. X is related to y. That means what? X comma y. X comma y. But in the place of y, what is the condition they have given? X squared. And also, what is the x? What type of number the x should be? X is a number. X is a prime number less than 13. That means you have to find out the prime number. You know, 1 is neither prime nor composite. 1 is neither prime nor composite. 2 is the only even prime number. 2 is the only even prime number. First, you should know what is meant by prime number. Prime number means what? It has only 2 devices, 2 factors. It is divisible by 1 and the number itself. So, 2 have only 1 and 2. Not other than these two. Next, 3 is a prime number. 3 is divisible by 1 and the number itself. 1 and 3 alone. Other than these two, you should not take the remaining even numbers. Only 2 is the only one even prime number. That means 4 you should not take. Next one is what? 5. 5 is divisible by 1 and 5 alone. 6 you should not take. Why? 6 is an even number. Next is 7. 7 also it is divisible by 1 and 7. 8 is the even number. So you should not take. 9. 9 why I am not taking is 9 is divisible by 1, 9. And also it is divisible by 3. 3 threes are 9. So you should not take 9. 10 is even number. Next one, 11. 11 is divisible by 1 and 11. It is divisible by 1 and the number itself. 13. But what is the condition they have given? Less than 13. So is it necessary to check 13? No. Then, what are the numbers you got for x? X belongs to here. X belongs to 2, 3, 5, 7, 11. So, just you write, try to write the ordered pair. What are the ordered pair you will get? Actually, what is the condition? X comma x squared, that means 2 comma 2 squared. Next one is 3 comma 3 squared. 4 comma 4, sorry. Very sorry, Dakana. 5 comma 5 squared. 7 comma 7 squared. 11 comma 11 squared. Here, 2 there is no change, isn't it? Next to 3 also there is no change. Here 5 also there is no change. 7 also there is no change. 11 also there is no change, isn't it? For the late bloomers purpose I have wrote like this. 2 squared is what? 4. 2 squared is what? 4. 3 squared is 9. 2 2s are 4. 3 3s are 9. 5 5s are 25. Next, 7 7s are 49. 11 11s are 121. 11 into 11. I told you the easy way, Vedic Max. You have to take the unit place. 1 into 1, 1. same way you have to take the same numbers. 1 plus 1 is 2. Again this 1, 1 is 1, 121. Otherwise as usual you do it. Do you follow? So 4, 9, 25, 49, 121. What are they asking? Range. Range is what? Y is an element of B. That means second element. What is the answer then? 4, 9, 25, 49, 121. So what is the answer? Many students, what you are making mistake is, you are taking this. First you should know the basic concept what you have studied in smaller classes. One is neither prime nor composite. One is divisible by one alone. The number also one, then one also there. So one is neither prime nor composite. So 4, 9, 25, 49, 121. The second element of the pairs. Do you follow? And also you have studied the relation. It is a subset of codomain. It is the subset of codomain. So is it necessary to do all these type of steps? No. Just by seeing this, you have to find out this alone. You have to find out this alone. This also mentally you can do. Because from smaller classes onwards, you are studying this. So after finding out this, very well you can write. 2 squared is 4. 3 squared is 9. 5 squared is 25. 7 squared is 49. 11 squared is 125. So it is enough to do this single step alone. After doing this, directly you can write this answer. No need to write all these things. But I told you what? While you are learning for first time, it is better to do many steps and basic concept. You revise everything. After that, you can go for the speedy way.